In the LHC, we have two beams which are accelerated in opposite directions. Then collisions take place between these two beams in four points. These collisions gradually reduce the intensity or the number of protons left inside the beams. And at some point, we need to extract the beams and dump them using the beam dumping system. The HL-LHC upgrade is increasing the amount of stored energy which can be present inside each beam. And we did the studies to see what impact this would have on the beam dump design, and we found out that some developments needed to be made to produce a beam dump design which could withstand these increased energies.
In the experiment, we have 16 targets which look like this, which are divided into four target stations, so each holding four of those targets, and every single one of these targets contains 20 material specimens. The experiment tank houses the four target stations, so two target stations on each side of the tank.
We're testing three different materials and have some specimens here. Firstly, we have two materials which are currently used inside the beam dumps. Firstly, we have this isostatic graphite, which means that when it's produced, it's made out of this fine powder which is pressed equally in all directions to produce very uniform material properties. And then we have flexible graphite, which is produced in quite a different way to produce a different behaving material that's very lightweight, feels almost like cardboard, feels very different to the isostatic graphite. Then thirdly, we have a new material, which is called carbon fiber reinforced carbon. It's a composite material made out of fibers and a carbon-based matrix. And it's normally used in very high temperature applications, like on the space shuttle re-entry for the high temperatures that are generated. And we want to use it because of its extremely good mechanical properties and its resistance to impact.
The experiment took place in the HiRadMat facilities, which stands for High Radiation to Materials. It's an underground facility which is connected to the SPS, the superproton synchrotron, a pre-accelerator to the LHC. So this is where the facility gets the beam pulses from. And it presents a really unique opportunity to test materials under similar conditions as we will have in future accelerators.
During the experiment, we monitor everything remotely from the CERN control center.
So on this screen with the yellow and white lines, what you see there is essentially the SPS supercycle. So currently we have in the middle our experiment, and we're just approaching our experiment right now. So the little jumps that you're seeing are the proton bunch trains that are injected. So we have four injections of 72 bunches each, so we have 288 bunches in total. And then the white lines, the magnets are being ramped up. And when you see the yellow line go down, this is when the beam is ejected from the SPS. And for every ejection, we can decide if we want to inject the beam into our experiment or if we dump it. With the purple line, what you see there is the injection intensities of the different bunch trains, the mean intensity as well as the accumulated intensity. Once we finished the experiment, we had to wait for 3 weeks, first of all, to let the radiation levels in the tank and the targets reduce to safe levels. And then once the experiment was essentially safe to handle, we dismounted it from its stand in the experiment facilities, transported it up to the surface, and then to a bunker to do the dismantling process of the experiment. We started extracting the targets from the aluminium sleeves to plexiglass sleeves, which look like this, to prepare them for further processing in a microcomputer tomography scan to see if there's any internal damage to the materials. Really similar to sort of standard CT scans in medicine, just with a much finer resolution.
Looking at the results of the experiment then, we didn't detect any damage in any of the isostatic graphite or carbon-carbon composite grades that we tested, either in the nominal or accidental scenarios, which is really good news. The expanded graphite that we tested, which is one of the older materials that we've used inside the dumps, was damaged in both scenarios, which effectively rules it out from use in the high-lumi dumps. This result is great news for the preliminary design of the HL-LHC beam dumps because it really gives us the maximum flexibility in the choice of materials for these dumps. It's been an amazing opportunity to run an experiment like this. where we started with quite a simple question of whether we could find materials which could survive high luminosity conditions inside the beam dumps, consulting many technical experts in different disciplines to converge to a design which ended up working extremely well.
So many different sections, so many different parts of CERN kind of come together to make this happen, and to see everyone really going the extra mile to make sure that we're getting valid results, and just kind of see this really incredible machine coming together with our experiment was really astonishing.